ImageLine have recently released a new FL Studio update, and I've heard of a couple crazy features that I thought might be interesting. So in today's one, I'm going to be making a beat using the new FL Studio beta. Also, real quick before I start, I wanted to say a big thank you to Hugo Versant for putting me onto the new update, because it came out like 3 weeks ago and I didn't even know it existed. And of course, for all the FL Studio users, I'll leave the update link in the description just in case. All right, so I'm in FL Studio. I'm right off the jump. I'm not really noticing anything too different. All right, yeah, this is new. All right, what is this? Okay, I think this is the FL Cloud that everyone's been talking about. So, all right, so they basically just put Splice into FL Studio. I guess I can just close down my second monitor then. Good afternoon. Is he even greeting me, bro? Does Splice greet me? I don't think so. All right, so you got Discover. Sounds, packs, most popular. All right, so there's a chart system. These packs definitely remind me of when Splice first came out, I'm not gonna lie. It's quite a sizable number of them, you know. I don't really know what I'm looking to make this time. I'm just kind of looking through the library and just seeing what's up. And I'm assuming you can like them, add them to your collection, and then I just drag and drop. That's pretty cool. This might be the first time since 2017 where I haven't opened Splice when making a beat. Let's see what else they have. This feels like Netflix or something, bro. Trap guitars. There's a couple decent ones in here. I'm assuming FL Cloud is like community driven or something, and that's why there's not that many sounds, but I'm thinking maybe this one. You can change the key of it. I didn't even know that. Okay. You can even control the playback speed. I mean, this is quite unnecessary, but it's pretty cool. All right, I reckon I'm just gonna drag this in and see what I can do with it. I'm just gonna turn it to like 140 because that's like a more versatile BPM for me. All right, so this loop is already marketed as R and drill, but I'm not really feeling that for this loop. I'm thinking maybe I'll switch it up for this one. Maybe like Jersey drill or something, or Afro. I'm not too sure. Okay, I don't really like this part of the sample. So I think what I'm gonna do is cut that out. I'm just gonna replace this part with the riff from the 8th bar. Sounds much better to me. I think now I'm gonna pitch it down a couple semitones. I'm gonna layer like a really quick effects chain on there, nothing too special. I may have added a couple too many effects, but it's okay, I'll move on. All right, now I'm gonna start a new pattern. All right, the guitar sounding way too thin and metallic for me, so I'm going to layer it with something from Serum, I think. For that, I'm going to open up Splice. The first sound I add to it, I've already failed the challenge of not opening up Splice. Okay, well, both of the tools are pretty good. I don't think one tool has to invalidate the other one, so. I think I'm just gonna follow the root notes of the guitar. I'm going to layer that with another pad though, so I'm going to go back into Serum and see what I can find. I feel like the guitar melody reminds me of something, but I just can't remember. Alright, now real quick, I'm going to add a bassline to this. Somewhere now. I want some sort of top line melody as well to go with it. So for that, I'm gonna open up Session Guitarist. I don't use it too much anymore, but it's really nice for like trap melodies and stuff like that. I don't know how I'm going to turn this into like Jersey or Afro or anything like that, but I'll see what I can do. I do want some sort of arpeggiated element, but these normally sound pretty cool and they're always kind of subtle, so. I think I'm just going to copy and paste the chords into Mallet Flux and just remove a couple of the notes. bury in the background to the point you can barely hear it, but that's kind of what I want. I'm gonna add like one more melodic element, I think, and I might as well use FL Cloud for it. Why not? Let's just try again. I could probably use that. I'm gonna have to pitch up slightly though. I should probably mix before doing this, but I do kind of want to add drums first. I don't really know what drums I want to use, so I think I'm just going to pick out a couple of Afrobeat sounds and just see what I come up with. Kick's really not hitting hard enough for me. I think I'm gonna add a couple more kicks on top of it. I'm gonna add this one as well. And I think this drum pattern's lacking some sort of consistent element. I'm gonna go into the Cuba Spotlight collection and use the cajon instrument. I'm gonna lay down a really simple pattern, I think. When I added a repeating element, the drum loop sounds a lot nicer, sounds a lot more complete. I'm gonna add a couple of percussion loops as well. That one's a lot more chaotic, but I think if I turn down the volume a bit, it should sound pretty nice. I'm gonna whip out splice again for like the fifth time. Look for a couple of shaker samples. I feel like I'm finally getting somewhere with the drums now. I want some sort of metallic percussion loops, like a triangle, a tambourine, something like that. I'm having that. What I'm gonna do just before mixing though, I'm gonna clone this drum pattern and I'm going to rearrange the drums so it makes some sort of like Jersey club bounce. Gonna lay the other drums on top of that, and then I'm gonna add like the classic snap to it as well. All right, I'm very happy with this 8-bar loop that I've got going on. I think probably the most difficult step now is to mix and arrange everything. It's gonna take me a while to mix everything, but it's gonna be worth it. Kind of reminds me of like something from Jordan at the Tsunji, so I might have a look around for an acapella like that or something. I don't know. Took a while, but I think I've finally mixed and arranged everything, and as I anticipated, there was a lot going on, so there was definitely a lot of EQing involved. I also did bounce out a couple of the melodic elements because the CPU load was way too high. I've added some orchestral samples as well to help introduce some of the drum patterns. Jordan at the Tunji released a track called Can't Lose recently, I think, and the vocals are crazy, so I thought I'd try and stem separate the sample inside of FL Studio rather than going to a third party. So if I click on the sample and then extract stems from sample, and I can pick and choose exactly what stems I want, which is kind of crazy. Loki, this is what I'm really interested in. Like, FL Cloud is cool, but this is the thing I'm going to be using the most often. And I think I just want the vocals for now, so I'm going to extract it. All right, it's finally done. It didn't actually take that long. It took like 2 minutes, but... But I feel like that's better quality than I get on like a stem splitter or something. And it took like half the time as well, so I'm very happy with that. And it's not just vocals either, like you can extract drums and bass lines with this. It's insane. I'm definitely going to be using that in future videos. Okay, before that, I'm just going to play the hook or chorus or whatever of the beat before hearing what it sounds like with an acapella. I added like some sort of house bass line to the Jersey Club bounce part, and I don't really know if it works. I don't know if I'm gonna keep it. I think I'll see how I feel when I play it with the acapella. Don't really know what to say about that. Kind of hard to believe that I put all of this together with like a 5 second long guitar sample that I found on FL Cloud, but still not completely sold on the house bass. I'm not gonna lie, I might take it out, I'm not sure. The whole beat's still very busy and I think the acapella doesn't really help. I don't know what I'd had to remove in order to fix that, probably a couple of the shaker loops. And I think once I've made a couple more beats in this genre or style, the mixing and stuff will sort of iron itself out. So I'm not too worried about that. And if someone could please let me know what the name of this genre is, cause I genuinely have no idea. Regardless, I think I'm pretty happy with how it turned out. Once again, of course, thank you for watching. And hopefully if you're looking for some sort of inspiration, this video helped you in some way. And of course, if you did enjoy the video, feel free to like and subscribe. So let's just listen to the final beat and see what I could do better for next time.